In this video, we will investigate the Bloch sphere. This is a geometrical representation of a quantum state in a two-level system, named after the Swiss physicist Felix Bloch. Being a two-level system means that we can have two basis states. So this is, for example, what a single qubit represents, which is in a superposition of 0 and 1. Another example could be a spin 1/2 particle, which is in a superposition of spin up and spin down. These two basis states are usually put at the north and south poles of the Bloch sphere. And any other point on the surface of this sphere corresponds to certain superpositions of 0 and 1, or up and down. Note that this is only true for pure quantum states, whereas mixed states lie within the Bloch sphere. Before we go into too much detail, we can already point out one important fact about the Bloch sphere. States that lie on opposite points on the sphere are orthogonal to each other, as you can immediately verify by looking at the north and south poles. The intuitive guess would have been that opposite points have a relative minus sign. However, such a minus sign is exactly the overall phase that we cannot observe in quantum mechanics, and therefore it's not represented by the Bloch sphere. Now let's see which point on the sphere corresponds to which superposition. Generally, our quantum state can be written as alpha times 0 plus beta times 1, where, due to the normalization condition, the absolute squares of alpha and beta have to add up to 1. A very general ansatz for alpha and beta is to write them in terms of sine and cosine functions, with additional phase factors since they are complex numbers. However, as we mentioned, an overall phase does not play a role, so only the relative phase is important, which we call omega. Now we want to connect the remaining two parameters, gamma and omega, to the spherical coordinates theta and phi. Remember that theta starts at the z-axis and goes down from there, taking on values between 0 and pi. The angle phi starts at the x-axis, goes around horizontally, and can take on values between 0 and 2 pi. So in order to have the state 0 at the north pole, we demand that if theta is 0 and phi is at any value, only the coefficient in front of 0 remains. At the south pole, for theta equal to pi and phi at any value, we want to have the state 1. You can easily verify that if we set gamma to be theta over 2 and omega equal to phi, this fulfills all requirements. Now let's talk about why the Bloch sphere is so useful. If we consider any direction on the Bloch sphere, parametrized by the usual spherical coordinates, the corresponding quantum state is an eigenfunction of the spin operator in that direction with positive eigenvalue. We can verify this by writing the spin operator in the direction n by using Pauli matrices and calculating how every Pauli matrix acts on a basis state, which we will now denote by up and down arrows. When we let the spin operator act on psi, we get many terms, where we can first let the Pauli matrices act on up and down. After isolating the coefficients of the basis states, we can further simplify the terms by using Euler's formula. Finally, we can use some trigonometric identities to reduce everything back to psi. So, to recap, for any point on the sphere with theta and phi, the corresponding Bloch state is an eigenfunction to the spin operator in that same direction with positive eigenvalue plus h bar over 2. To get the negative eigenvalue, we have to go to the opposite side of the sphere. Now we can solve problems like this one. Imagine that you have a random mix of spin up and spin down states. You now perform a measurement and measure spin up in the x direction. What is the quantum state after the measurement? To find out, we need to know the direction of the positive x-axis, which in spherical coordinates is pi over 2 and 0. Using these values in the Bloch state yields 1 over the square root of 2 times up plus down. Or what if you measure spin down in the y direction? This means we need to know the coordinates of the negative y-axis, which points towards the spherical coordinates pi over 2 and 3 pi over 2. This yields 1 over the square root of 2 times up minus I down. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.